You Squared, Chapter 1. Imagine standing on the edge of possibility, knowing deep down that there's a greater version of yourself waiting to emerge. A version capable of extraordinary achievements. But how do you get there? How do you make that quantum leap in life where you go beyond just doing more of the same and instead break into a whole new realm of success? Well, today we're diving into an exciting idea, a concept that can propel your life forward in ways you never thought possible. We're talking about You Squared, a powerful concept introduced by Price Pritchett in the first chapter of his transformational book, You Squared. This is a principle that calls us to rethink the way we pursue growth and success, moving from incremental improvements to exponential results. Let's explore how to make this leap. Quantum leaps versus incremental progress. Pritchett introduces the idea that we often approach success in small linear steps. We think the only way to progress is by putting in more effort or spending more time. However, this belief limits us. In reality, the most significant breakthroughs come from not doing more of the same, but from making a quantum leap, a sudden, dramatic shift that launches us forward in a way that feels almost effortless. Imagine it like leaping across the canyon instead of trying to slowly walk down into it and up the other side. Now, what does this mean for you? It means that sometimes the path to greatness isn't through grinding away at the same methods, but by completely rethinking your approach. Change your strategy, not just your efforts. So, the first chapter challenges us to break free from the idea that working harder is the only answer. Often, it's not about doing more, but doing different. Pritchett uses the analogy of a fly trying to escape through a closed window. It can continue buzzing and exhausting itself, trying harder and harder to break free, but no amount of effort will lead to success. Just a few feet away, there's an open door that requires no struggle. To escape, the fly doesn't need more effort. It needs to change its strategy. And for us, this means recognizing when we're stuck in an unproductive cycle and being willing to try something new. It's not about the quantity of effort, but the quality of action that leads to exponential growth. Leverage the power of belief. A quantum leap starts with the belief that you are capable of more. If you believe that success only comes from gradual, incremental improvement, you'll be stuck in that pattern. But if you allow yourself to believe in the possibility of massive, sudden growth, you open the door to it. Now, Pritchett encourages us to think big, to set aside the limitations we've placed on ourselves, and to trust in our potential for quantum success. Just ask yourself, what would you attempt if you truly believed in exponential growth? What bold moves would you make if you knew you could achieve massive results in a fraction of the time? Trust the process. The path to a quantum leap may not always be clear. In fact, it may feel uncertain or risky. But that's where trust comes in. Pritchett reminds us that to achieve You Squared, we need to trust in the process. Believe that even though we can't see every step, we are moving in the right direction. It's about letting go of the need to control every detail and instead following a vision that pulls us forward with faith and determination. Now, the idea of a quantum leap isn't just about working harder. It's about thinking differently, acting boldly, and believing in the possibility of extraordinary success. As you move forward, I encourage you to pause and reflect. Where in your life are you stuck in the fly against the window mentality? And ask yourself, what bold new strategy could I embrace that might open the door to new and entirely greater levels of achievement in my life. Remember, greatness isn't a matter of slow, steady progress. It's about stepping into your full potential and taking a leap, a quantum leap, into the life you were meant to live. The door is open. Will you step through it? Thank you. Tomorrow we're going to discuss Chapter 2.